Good evening. I'm Nicholas Hoare for Vermont PBS, and this is the other feline character in the Hoare House by the name of Toto, who sports six on each paw. Nina Campbell is a legend in her time, an extraordinarily successful decorator who's been practicing her profession in London for close to 50 years. She comes by it honestly, having joined a wonderful company called Colefax and Fowler when she was still in her teens. John Fowler, her mentor and employer, was the gentleman who singled her out from the pack and retained her as his personal assistant as the company grew. She grew with the company and indeed with John Fowler and stayed there for 3 years, but obviously was growing restive. At the end of the 3 year, shall we say, training period, she branched off on her own at a very young age indeed and set up shop in a darling little street right behind Harrods called Walton Street, where she has continued to practice her profession for over 40 years. She has a delightful shop which carries all her goods and chattels, ranging from fabrics to wallpapers to bibelots to you name it. One of which, the fabrics anyway, I'm standing in front of. This is a typical Nina Campbell floral, and it is called Montacute. It's of interest to me because this sort of thing you do not find outside a certain, shall we say, milieu. This is vintage Campbell. Nina Campbell has developed in association with Sir Peter Osborne and Anthony Little of Osborne and Little fame, a line of fabrics and wallpapers which is absolutely peerless. It's an absolute delight. This house alone has two or three dotted around, and they really are special. But the most interesting thing about her is that a succession of books have been written either about or by her, which I think, anyway, epitomize her style. One of them, which came out in 1996, was called The Art of Decoration. This was the precursor to two more that came out later. But the original, this one here, was much more to do with the style she followed than the actual practice, how it was done. The other one, which came out in 2000, does just that, covers how to, where to go, and so forth. And that is called Nina Campbell's Decorating Secrets. And as an example, if I open it up, I have the introductory page, which singles it out from the pack, in which it says where to begin, the decoration, and finishing touches split into chunks. So for example, under decoration, you have halls, drawing rooms, dining rooms, things of the past, kitchen, dining, studies and libraries, bedrooms and bathrooms. But you also have a chunk devoted to finishing touches, which include cushions, tassels, window treatments, floors and walls, displaying collections, objets d'art, and so forth. This is the practical side of Nina Campbell. But most interesting, and that's really why we're doing this, is the latest book, which is less than a year old, called Nina Campbell Interior Decoration, subtitled Elegance and Ease. And this time it is not herself doing the writing. It's a wonderful author called Giles Kime, who comes by his trade, honestly, as well. His father's very well known in the field. And the book is a delight. This is a catalogue raisonné, if you will, of her styles as they have evolved. And whereas 20 years ago there was a slightly David Hicks overtone to her work, loud colors, very, very laid back, now it's more modern. And you have the taupes and you have the pale grays and you have the softer tones. So I'm just going to riff through this to give you a visual idea of where she is now, and you will see that things have softened and her style has matured. She's moved with the times. She hasn't stayed stationary. And the wonderful thing about her design work is that every single one of her settings is different from its predecessor. Take an example here. We have a room with an infuriatingly sharp angle that reflects the eaves of the house. How to deal with the window? Well, what she's done is create a shutter which is embossed with fabric. So she avoids the necessity of having picture rails, as it were, going over the top, curtain rods, and she can actually put a protective and extremely decorative facade to the windows, quite independent of what people would normally design. Original, colorful, and sharp. Further on, we have an example of her own bedroom. This, I think, is the one she's currently living in because she has a habit, quite rightly, of developing houses and flipping them. And she's gone through a succession of them, all of them in her home turf, which is Chelsea or South Kent. So this is an example of her recent work. And again, you can see the evolution of a style and the fact that she's come a great distance in the years that she has been practicing her work. On your left, you will see the interior of a well-known nightclub in London called Annabel's. She was responsible, with a gentleman called Mark Birley, for designing that particular club, which of course is one of the most famous in England. Nina Campbell is a wonderful person to get to know, and you can see anytime her products, the fruits of her labors, if you go to an agent, North American agent, of Osborne and Little. Osborne and Little is her agent of long standing, and as I say, they have the whole works at their disposal. I recommend her work and this book very warmly. And on that decorative note, good evening.